Morning.
Morning.
The usual?
No, not anymore.
We're here at the Belfry and we've been able to get our hands on the new TaylorMade P790 irons. We're going to put these up against the TaylorMade M5, P760s and the previous P790 and show you how they all compare. I'm going to head inside now and put these in our test pro hands, Neil Wain, and then I'll tell you a bit more about how these have been updated for 2019. We've hit quite a few shots there, guys. So let's just start off by just telling you a little bit more about these new P790 irons. Basically, the original P790s have been in TaylorMade's range for 2 years. They were launched in August 2017. And the long irons especially have been in the bags of Rory, DJ, Jason Day. So they've been really, really popular. And especially here in Europe, and maybe in the US as well, the P790 original was the biggest selling forged iron that TaylorMade have ever made, which is absolutely incredible. Yeah. And it means that when they've approached the redesign, they've done it really, really carefully because they didn't really want to upset the apple cart and come in with a completely different design. They knew that this was working. So what's different about it? Well, basically the profile in the shorter irons is a little bit more compact from toe to heel. They've reduce the offset in the longer irons so that you get a little bit more of a player's look to it.
Yep.
And also the face has been thinned down. So that means that they've been able to put some extra weight, another 15% weight in the tungsten weight, which is right behind the face. But essentially, Neil, they are pretty much like the original P790s.
Yeah, originally, like I say, the first glance, I hit some of the old P790s and then you handed me the new one. When they weren't together, I felt like I couldn't see a huge difference. However, when I sat them down side by side, there is a little bit of a difference. Definitely, the old one, 100% has a straighter, a lot squarer leading edge,
yeah.
A little bit more rounded on the new ones. And then when I started hitting a few of the new ones, it makes it's a different sound. Mm-hmm. I reckon that the tungsten weight in there definitely has an impact on that.
Yeah, so it's right behind the face rather than having a disc which is slightly toeward in the original one, so you really feel like it's a pretty good feel to them.
Yeah, and also it felt like I was still, because the old ones feel really hot, don't they? You can tell they're built for speed, high ball speed off a 7.9. I felt like I really wasn't losing any speed with these, but I'm still getting the great feel. Mm-hmm. And like we both agreed, they definitely make a better sound than the old model.
Okay, great. And just to be clear as well, we say forged model. What that actually means with this particular model, the same as the original, is that the actual body of the iron is cast from 8620 steel, whereas the face is forged from 4140 steel. So it's a forged face, not a forged body. Another update is the shafts. So dynamic gold 105, but they've got a vibration dampening system, which you found really helped when you hit a couple off Sentinel.
Yeah, well, I'll be honest, when you mentioned it to me, I was a little bit skeptical. I couldn't see it making a huge difference, but it actually does. I remember hit one, I don't know, six or seven balls in and got that one a little bit low on the face, a little bit short right, and didn't really feel much through the hands. So it's normally get that little bit of vibration, don't you? A little bit of a tingling sensation through the fingers, but didn't really get that, Simon. So I felt like with a miss it, I'm going to put my neck on the line a little bit and say that these are going to be a little bit more forgiving than the old ones, definitely.
Okay. It's worthwhile just pointing out as well, at the same time that TaylorMade are launching a new P790 UDI, and that's the one that's been really, really popular on tour, Neil.
Yeah, a lot of guys using this. Again, I think the reason for this would be compact looking ad, but it produces phenomenal ball speeds, which is going to lead to the distance that the guys are looking for.
Okay, just to be clear, we've not hit it today. We might well include it in a future video, but this this video was really about the P790s and how they compare against other irons in the TaylorMade range. So that's pretty much the story behind the new P790s. And let's head over to the Wall of Wisdom and we'll see how they compare in terms of data. Just to be clear, guys, we've created all of this data using a SkyTrack launch monitor and range balls because a lot of people still get fitted on a range using range balls. So it makes sense for us to give you the data that you will see when you go and get fitted. Just to be clear as well, there's 3 degrees of loft difference between these irons going from the P760 through to the M5 being the strongest. So that will have an effect on ball speed, launch angle, spin, and obviously carry distance. Okay, Neil, just start off, you know, just talk us through the numbers.
Yeah, so the thing that strikes me firstly, Simon, would be the spin rate on the P760, 6,500. Pretty good spin number, that really, for myself. And it's more than the rest, greater spin than the rest. That's something that I'd expect to see, though. Player's iron, smaller head, a little bit more loft. It's gonna lead to more spin.
Cool. Okay, just moving on to the M5, because we really feel if you're looking at the P790, that you should be considering M5 as well. They are pretty much aimed at the similar type of player. Or what happened on M5, Neil?
Yeah, so looking at M5 over P760, you can see there's a gain there. Obviously, 9 yards in the carry. They come out a little bit hotter, mm-hmm. A bit lower, hence why they're a little bit more carry there. You can see there, ball speed, 122 over 118. But you've got to consider, again, a little bit stronger in loft, aren't they?
Yeah. And spin is actually pretty good, and that comes down to the XP shafts in there, doesn't it? You know, that launches a little bit higher.
Yeah, I dare say that if you were to have the same shaft in the M5 as what you've got in the 760, it would be far too low spinning. So it's a good little thing that TaylorMade have done there. They've got a little bit of higher spinning, higher launching shaft in there to counteract how strong the face is on that M5.
Okay, just to be clear, it doesn't launch any higher for you personally, but it spins more.
Yeah.
Okay, that's something that you need to think about if you were to go and get fitted. Okay, just moving on to old P790 against new P790. And to be fair to TaylorMade, this is one product they're not really coming out and saying, this is gonna go further, this is gonna go further, it's faster. What they are saying is that if you compare the new head against the old head, you will get more ball speed. But because at the turn of the year, TaylorMade changed their standard shaft lengths. The shaft length on the new P790 is a little bit shorter compared to what it is in the old P790. So effectively, you're getting some more control, but you're not losing any ball speed. You're actually gaining a fraction of ball speed.
Yeah, so that's it's a very good point that you've made that, Sam, because you'll tend to find that guys that are using a longer shaft, yes, you can swing it quicker, but it's obviously more difficult to find the middle of the club. So I'm a big fan of what they've done there with the new one, getting it a little bit shorter. And I felt like I was striking a little bit more consistently with the shorter shaft. So yeah, good point, definitely.
Okay, so the question that everyone really wants to know the answer to is if you already have a set of P790s, should you go and update? And to be fair to TaylorMade, they're not really the target customer, are they?
No, they aren't, no. If you were to go and update, there are some the changes in there that do, there are benefits. It has definitely moved forward for me personally if I was to use them. I would use the newer model. I like the, like I've discussed before, the leading edge being a little bit more rounded, but it's that feel with the tungsten weight. But one thing that I am impressed with, and it's backed up the theory, that shorter shaft, we've actually, I know it's only 1 mile an hour, but it's still a gain, isn't it? 3 yards extra carry, that's quite a big gain for somebody of my ability, definitely.
Okay, so that isn't actually the end of the story. That what we haven't told you so far is that what TaylorMade have done with the new P790 is just tailor it slightly down to the better player eye. And what they've done on the opposite end of the scale, because they know that the original P790 irons, they found their way into bags of players with +4 handicappers and 25 handicappers. So a massive, massive audience of golfers. What TaylorMade really wanted to do was make sure that they had a P-series iron that worked in more of a game improver's hands. So what they've done is they've created a P790 Ti, and we've not been able to test it. We don't have a model here. I've actually seen one myself and it does look absolutely amazing. So the whole head is created out of titanium and there's 117 grams worth of tungsten in one single weight, very, very low and deep. And The head's a fraction bigger, there's a fraction more offset compared to the standard P790. But what TaylorMade is saying is that this will work really, really well in players' hands that don't quite have the same ball striking ability that you need to be able to hit the P790s. So we can't give you any more information on those yet, but what I would say is if you're really looking at buying a set of P790s and you're not really a player, that you think they might be just above your ability, it would be worth waiting until you see the P790 TIs just to be able to compare them. The other thing that you really, really need to know is that the titanium irons are not going to be cheap. We don't have a confirmed pricing yet, but it looks like they're probably going to be between £2,000 and £3,000 a set because of their high-tech construction. You know, that's a bit of a trend in golf, isn't it, Neil? Yeah. Brands going with high-tech models, aimed at. They've seen that PXG, you know, have created a new market, you know, with very, very high-tech irons, aimed at very, very premium price points. So that essentially is the type of customer that the P790 TIs are aimed at. If you like the video, guys, hit the like and subscribe button. And if you've got any comments or questions, leave them below, and we promise to answer every single sensible one. We'll see you next time.